Hey guys, Luke Bowles here, and today I'm going to be giving you guys one of the two trailer reactions that I said yesterday that I was going to upload today. And one of them being, of course, a four-part trailer reaction, a trailer reaction video where I react to four trailers in one video. You kind of get the picture of it, I just wanted to say. Anyway, so I will be reacting to four trailers. The first one, I think I will react to the first, the second official trailer for Avengers Endgame. The second trailer I will react to would probably be Toy Story 4 official trailer. Okay, the third trailer that I will react to is the Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, you know, the upcoming Quentin Tarantino film starring Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, and the rest of the A-list actors. The official trailer for that film will be the third one I'll react to, and the fourth and last trailer that I will react to in this four-part trailer reaction video is the second official trailer for John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. So, now let's react to Avengers Endgame official trailer number 2, I think. Yeah, I think this is the first, or second official trailer. Let's get started.
Like 1,000 years ago, I fought my way out of that cave.
Became showing a couple of shots from Iron Man. That's really cool.
Realized I loved you. I know I said no more surprises, but
I'm hearing the Avengers theme.
One last one.
The world has changed.
Man, so many callbacks. Or flashbacks, rather.
All we can do is our best. And sometimes the
there
best
he is. There he is.
Start over.
I saw all these people die. Keep telling everybody they should move on. Some do, but not us.
Even if there's a small chance, we owe this to everyone who's not in this room to try.
We will. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Oh, the white suits. Wow. Nice. And then there's the last shot. I have seen this before.
I like this one.
Yep. Yeah, that's a pretty funny shot, I will say. Avengers, this is a different trailer than the first trailer, which is kind of surprising. I didn't think that this trailer would show as many flashbacks to some of the previous films, especially ones in Phase 1 of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, as I thought it would show. But it showed more. It showed plenty of flashbacks to some of the scenes in some of the first installments of the MCU, which is, again, very interesting and very surprising. Didn't think I would see that many, but that's cool. So, and I really like how this is showing like some of the main Avengers like trying to team up to trying to band together and try to find a way to get back on the right track. And so it's very interesting. And I am really, obviously, I'm really excited for Avengers Endgame. In fact, no, I'm so super hooked on seeing Avengers Endgame and how it will end. Now, I do find it interesting, though. Now, I do find it interesting, and I didn't notice this until now. I don't think there's any shot of Thanos in the trailer. Like there's only, we only see Thanos in one shot in the first trailer, where you see him like walking through his, I guess you could say, farmyard. You know, somewhere he like uses his gauntlet on the sea or on the weeds and stuff like that. Kind of similar to in Gladiator, when, you know, a Russell Crowe like walks through. But you guys know what I'm talking about if you have watched Gladiator. Because if you hadn't watched Gladiator, what are you doing in life? What are you doing? Please watch it. But anyway, that we only see one shot of Thanos in the first trailer. In this trailer, we haven't seen, there was no sign of Thanos at all. We have not seen Thanos in any shot of this trailer, which is very interesting. Because in Avengers Infinity War, the film mostly focuses on Thanos, more so than it focuses on the Avengers, at least most of them. But here, it seems like the film will now focus more on the Avengers rather than focus more on Thanos, because Thanos already accomplished what he wanted to accomplish, which is wipe out half of the universe by the snap of his fingers once he gets all the six Infinity Stones to his Infinity Gauntlet. So, yeah. Here it looks like the Avengers will get to regroup and try to get together and find a way to stop Thanos and undo all the things that he's done. Not just on Earth, but in the entire universe. So yeah, guys, again, I am so freaking amped to see Endgame. I really can't wait. I cannot wait. Give me that film right now. Now, the second trailer that I'm going to be reacting to right now is the official trailer for Toy Story 4, the fourth installment of my favorite animated Pixar trilogy of all time, period. It's just that simple. Anyway, Toy Story 4 official trailer, let's get.
Everyone, Bonnie made a friend in class.
She's already making friends.
No, she literally made a new friend. I want you to meet Forky.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
He's a spork.
Yes, yeah, I know. Forky is the most important toy to Bonnie right now. We all have to make sure nothing happens to him.
Woody, we have a situation.
I am not a toy. I was made for soup, salad, maybe chili, and then the trash.
Buzz, we've got to get Forky.
Affirmative.
Why am I alive?
You're Bonnie's toy. You are going to help create happy memories that will last for the rest of her life.
Huh? What?
Oh, yeah.
Bo? Forky, come on.
Bo?
Hi there. My name is Gabby Gabby.
We can't stay.
Yes, you can, boys.
Woody, behind you!
Bo! What are you doing here?
No time to explain. Come with me.
We need to get back to our kid.
Aw, Sheriff Woody, always coming to the rescue.
Bonnie needs Forky.
Woody, who needs a kid's room when you can have all of this?
Wow.
Woody, aren't we going to Bonnie?
What do we do, Buzz?
What would Woody do?
Jump out of a moving vehicle.
Let's go!
Hey, you gotta go, you gotta go.
If you should ever leave me.
You know, you've handled this lost toy life better than I could.
Open your eyes, Woody. There's plenty of kids out there. Sometimes change can be good.
You can't teach this old toy new tricks.
You'd be surprised.
Bonnie? We're going home, Forky.
God only knows.
Bonnie, I'm coming!
On my way, Woody!
To infinity and beyond!
Oh,
kaboom!
Don't let Woody leave.
Okay.
kids lose their toys every day.
I was made to help a child. I don't remember it being this hard.
Woody, somebody's whispering in your ear.
Everything's gonna be okay.
June 21st. I cannot wait, because I already made my first Q&A video on this, because someone has asked me what were my top three favorite Pixar movies of all time, and three of them were the Toy Story movies, the three installments of Toy Story, because to me, Toy Story has always been my favorite animated Pixar trilogy of all time, period. There has not been a single Pixar film that has been able to top the three Toy Story movies, in my personal opinion. None of them. Not even Finding Dory, Meet Nemo, which I liked, really loved. Not even A Bug's Life, which I also really loved. And not even The Incredibles, which I also really love. Not even those great, great films have been able to top any of the Toy Story movies for me. And because Toy Story is my favorite Pixar franchise of all time, and possibly one of my top five favorite animated trilogies of all time, or franchises, I should say, of all time, I am so, so excited to see Toy Story 4. It's honestly one of my top five most anticipated films of the year, period. Probably top four. I think it's number four on my list for top 10 most anticipated movies of 2019. I think it is. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm really excited for it. I can't wait. Tim Allen, Tom Hanks, both as Buzz Lightyear and Woody, as well as the rest of the crew. I mean, what can I say? I mean, how can I say no to a Toy Story movie? How can I not? I mean, seriously. And I think I heard someone said, or I think I heard an interview with both Tim Allen and Tom Hanks talking about how this might be the most emotionally, the most emotional, epically powerful, and yet very sweet, very amazing film in the entire Toy Story franchise. I heard an interview with them saying something along those lines, saying that it's more emotional and more amazing than the three Toy Story movies, which that's pretty big to say. But I am curious to see how this film will be like more emotionally sad yet amazing at the same time than the three other Toy Story movies. I'm curious to see how it'll be compared to the three other Toy Story movies, because those three Toy Story movies, you know, 1, 2, and 3, have not been topped as of yet in terms of Pixar movies that I love and are my favorites of all time. So yeah, we will just have to wait and see how Toy Story 4 will pan out, or will unfold once it's released in theaters, because I can't wait. As a Toy Story fan, I just cannot say no to Toy Story 4. I just can't. Okay, two down, two to go. The third trailer I'll be reacting to right now, is the official teaser trailer for the upcoming Quentin Tarantino film, and his ninth one is it's for Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, starring many A-list actors like Leonardo DiCaprio, Brad Pitt, and Margot Robbie, and plenty others. The hype for this movie is big, But in fact, it's actually humongous. I heard so much about this movie from many people talking about how excited they are about seeing this film. I don't know very much about Quentin Tarantino. I have not seen any other of his 8 films that he directed. One of them, what was it? Pulp Fiction, I heard about that. I heard about, what was it? Inglourious Basterds, Kill Bill, Django Unchained, and The Hateful Eight, which was, I think, his latest film that came out in 2015. So, I mean, I heard so much about Quentin Tarantino, and yet I haven't watched any of his films. But the hype surrounding this movie is makes me curious, and actually inspires me to want to watch this trailer. So, without any further ado, let's get on with it.
To my right is Bounty Law series lead and Jake Cahill himself, Rick Dalton. And to my left is Rick Stutt Double Cliff Booth.
Oh, showing the classic Columbia logo. That's nice. And that's kind of reasonable as to why, because of what this trailer is showing me right now.
Is that how you describe your job, Cliff?
What, carrying his load? Yeah, it's about right.
Margot Robbie, yep. I know there are others, I just can't remember.
Get into a fight, I accidentally kill you. I go to jail.
Anybody accidentally kills anybody in a fight, they go to jail. It's called manslaughter.
The best acting I've ever seen in my whole life.
Thank you.
Rick fucking dope.
That's really good. That's really good. That's really good. I like it. This is an interesting teaser trailer. This is an old fashioned look. A looking trailer. I mean, so much old-fashioned style. I'm not saying old-fashioned in a bad way. I'm just saying that, you know, it's very rare that I see a movie as well as a trailer for a movie that looks the same way this trailer looks. I mean, just being like the old style of Hollywood and of film and film directing and all that other stuff, all the filmmaking, the old style of it, the old fashioned a type of, you know, how Hollywood and how it is from back when it was created to how it is today. I mean, it looks really impressive, and I like the old style of this film. I like the style of it alone. As well as so many things, like, you know, seeing the A-list actors like Leonardo DiCaprio, he looks really good. Brad Pitt, he also looks really good. And Margot Robbie, she also looks really damn good. I will say, I mean, I just like what this trailer shows me, particularly with the Columbia logo, the classic Columbia logo. That's really nice. I dug it. And how it's like a square screen instead of like a full blown screen, a big one. I mean, that's really interesting. And I am curious to see how this film will turn out to be. I mean, I have to watch at least a few films by Quentin Tarantino before I watch this film, because I have not been familiar with any of his work, any of his filmography for that matter. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, I am curious to see this film. It's not one of my most anticipated films of the year, but it does look like the type of film that I would like to see, and I'm curious to see how it turns out. Okay, guys, this is the fourth and final trailer that I will react to in this four-part trailer reaction. So, this is the second official trailer, or new trailer, for John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum, with Keanu Reeves as John Wick. This is supposedly the final chapter of the John Wick franchise. So, it sure looks like it to me. So anyway, let's get right onto it. I don't have to say anything else before watching this trailer. Anyway. Of course everyone is waiting for John Wick. Cause he's a badass.
There's no idea what's coming.
Mr. Wick broke the rules. I trust you understand the repercussions if he survives.
John Wick, excommunicado, is now in effect.
You shouldn't be here.
Ooh.
Nice suit.
Good to see you too. I need your help.
After this, we are less than even.
Did you see what he just did? We're throwing multiple knives at that one dude. Man, that's hot.
Set the mood for our new guest.
Let us begin.
Our services still off limits to me. What do you need? Guns. Lots of guns. You think you can take John Wick?
But you can't.
You've got a nasty surprise coming.
You damn right.
I've been looking forward to meeting you for a long time.
Ooh.
And so far, you haven't disappointed.
We can keep this up as long as you'd like. But this only ends one way.
Nice. Very, very nice.
All of this for what? Because of a puppy?
Wasn't just a puppy.
It wasn't just a puppy. Very nice. I really dug it. Really dug it. Yeah, this is a great trailer. I dug it. I love it. A really great trailer. I'm so hyped for John Wick Chapter 3. It's one of my top three most anticipated movies of the year. I'm more excited for it than I have ever been ever since it was announced to be made, or was giving more updates that it's now in the post-production. I was excited for it at that time, but I wasn't like fully excited. But even before the first trailer came out, I was even more excited, especially after reading the synopsis for this film. And also some of the first look pictures of John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. It looks so badass. And I just want to see John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum so bad. Probably just as much as wanting to see Avengers Endgame. I mean, that's how hyped I am to see John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. I mean, this movie, and I think I said this before, and I think I'm going to probably say what I want to say for probably one video, I'll just say, talking about my anticipation for John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. But I will say that this movie has the potential to make this trilogy, to make this trilogy become one of the best action thrilling trilogies in cinema history of all time. It has a potential to turn John Wick into one of the best action trilogies of all time, period. Because the two John Wick films, particularly the first one, I freaking love. One of the best, John Wick, one of the best action movies I have seen in years, probably this past decade. So because of all of that, I can't wait to see how this supposed trilogy of John Wick will end. I really can't wait to see how this third movie will end up being. I can't wait to see it. I hope it's good, and I believe it's going to be really good. So anyway, guys, this is my four-part trailer reaction, or my reactions to all four trailers in this four-part trailer reaction video. I have one more trailer reaction to do after I'm through with this one, and it is my reaction to the official trailer for season 3 of Netflix's Stranger Things. Yeah, the official trailer came out a few days ago, so I wanted to react to that one. And then, once I'm through with my reaction to Stranger Things season 3 official trailer, or my reaction to the trailer, I will be doing a 2019 movie review. And it's for Cold Pursuit, starring Liam Neeson. So be on the lookout for that. Stay tuned here on my channel just for those, you know, videos that I will be uploading on my channel very soon. Probably within the next few days, so stay tuned. If you guys enjoyed this four-part trailer reaction, please click the like button, and if you watch any of these trailers, comment below to let me know what you think of them. If you enjoy what you've seen here and you want to see future videos from me, please press up there to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and I will see you guys in the next video. Have a great week, Battle Squad, and as always, fight the good fight.